Hi everyone, my name is Ian Van Tuyl and I'm coming to you from the bow of the all-new 2018 Jeanneau 490 Sun Odyssey. I can't tell you enough how incredible this particular vessel is. I am just overwhelmed by its innovation, its design, its styling, and its overall performance and handling characteristics. We are sitting on the brand new Sun Odyssey line that Philippe designed. This is a remarkable vessel. Some of the real key points to it is the hard shine going from the bow all the way to the stern section, giving you great stability and massive interior volume. Another key feature that I like in the design of bringing the gooseneck down on the boom really low, and it actually increases the sail area dramatically from having it in a traditional position about 2.5 feet up from where it's sitting right now. But it doesn't compromise anything in the cockpit for its design of the Dodger or Bimini because of the boom's angle and the cut of the sail. Another innovation is having the split shrouds here. It allows you great, easy access down into the cockpit. And as we're walking into the cockpit, this is a major innovation for the Sun Odyssey line. This is a gradual ramp that gets us right to the cockpit with no steps, no stepping on cushions, not even getting around people. I mean, I find this to be really impressive. The other thing I like about it is just the ease of access. So if I'm single-handing this boat or shorthand sailing, I can zip up to the bow, get my dock lines, get my fenders out with ease. The transom right here is electric, so it really optimizes the space that you have here. We have a dedicated locker here that's for the generator. So, and if you do not choose a generator, this is a large stowage compartment as well too. We have a hot and cold swim step shower located here and a fully accessible life raft locker. So it's easy to get a life raft out from here. It also hinges up so you have top access as well too if the transom is in the upright position. Propane locker space here and a full built-in sink. So this is a really innovative use of space here, incorporating a sink back here. So if you do some fishing, you know, and or barbecuing back here, you don't have to drape everything into the galley itself. You can do it right here in the cockpit. So centrally located is our cockpit table. But what's really unique about it is we have lighting throughout here. We also have our electric transom platform. So this allows us to raise and lower the transom. We also have a nice Plastimo compass. Our engine displays here, so when you're sitting at the helm, you have great unobstructed view of your display controls. This is a nice opening storage locker for bottles. And then we have a designated spot here for an isotherm 12-volt refrigerator. This is a cool unit because with this unit, you can actually take it out, unplug it, and take it with you. So it keeps all of your drinks and stuff cold, and if you're going into shore for the afternoon, you have a nice cooler to bring drinks in. So at the starboard helm, this is our main helm control. So this is where the throttle is, this is where the VHF is, our bow thruster control. But what I like about it is it's so accessible. So if I'm backing the boat up, I have easy throttle access here. I have great visual of my RPMs and a GPS display. There are two GPS displays, one in each helm as well. One of the final innovations for the deck is this amazing design here. This coaming comes back, lays into place, and creates this into a large lounge. There's also a filler cushion that comes into here. So it is quite nice. And this also does it on the port side as well too. So this is an option to get them both on starboard and port, but we've used this on this particular model. So let's go down below and see what it has to offer. So coming down below on the 490, great, easy, accessible steps here. We have our engine that's located right below here. What I really like about that is just the accessibility to everything. We have our primary filter here, our secondary filter, easy access to our impeller and sea strainer, and reservoir coolant is in the back with access on both starboard and port and behind the engine as well too. So great accessibility here. I really like the design here with the leather-wrapped stainless steel handles. And everywhere you go, there's always something to grab onto. Jeanneau has been known for being a true offshore performance cruiser. And everything through its innovation and design just really give you that comfort and peace of mind going offshore, from the small things, from handles and hull design and just the overall layout of the vessel. But let me move on to the boat itself and talk about the nav station. This, I think, is very impressive. And what I like about it is it almost creates a second salon table or a little cubby nook. So you have a great area to lay out charts, a great use of space, but you also have additional seating across from that too. So again, it has multiple uses, which I really like in the vessel itself. We have our multi-repeater here, our display that monitors our water, our electrical, and everything that we need to know about the ship system. Our VHF, our inverter controls, our 12-volt panel, and our Fusion stereo. They've also done some really nice touches with leather, adding a clock barometer, and really well done. So directly across the nav station is the day head and VIP head access. The head compartment also has a separate shower and a separate door that goes into the aft starboard VIP cabin. As we move up forward, just amazing amount of stowage, a countertop space, and a great use of space throughout the vessel itself. You have amazing amount of natural light that just floods the salon here. But as you can see, the salon table itself is quite nice. It has two leaves on both sides that open up, and it gives you a great U-shaped seating all the way around the table. I like this because you actually have easy access throughout. And also at the base here, there are two adjustable mounts that allow you to lower this table down and turn this into a bed and or a lounge area. You can see the attention to detail just from the lighting to the LED lights that are just covered here. We have shades and overhead opening hatches throughout, and it is quite impressive. As we move to the galley itself is set up in such a unique fashion. Now, the middle of the boat is one of the most stable positions on a boat. A lot of offshore cruisers actually love to make this their berth, and by having the center of gravity right here, this is one of the most stable places. So cooking underway is gonna be such a dream. We have large stowage compartments everywhere. We also have a top loading and side loading access to the refrigerator, a three burner stove and oven, and I love this. This is the pop-up microwave. So it gives you a great use of space. It also comes up and allows you to be able to put it away, stow it away, and then again, have that countertop space you need. Now, this was an upgraded option that we ordered. This is the additional fridge or freezer. So nice stainless steel compartments here, but you can have a deep freezer and or thermostat this down to a fridge. Lots of stowage found throughout and tons of subsole stowage as well too. Let's go up to the master, because this is a master that I've never really seen before or experienced. I've only seen this in like larger yachts, and I think what they've done is they've just really done a phenomenal job of shrinking this down to give you a truly eloquent master for a 50-foot boat. So let's go on in and check it out. All right, so as we come into the master cabin, behind the stateroom door is a separate head compartment. The separate head compartment houses an electric Japsco quiet flush toilet, a sink, and a great use of space. And then as we move into the main salon, you're gonna see, again, nice aviation shades, two overhead opening windows, and just a really nice open feel. There's lots of hanging locker stowage and shelving throughout, and there's shelving and stowage underneath the bed as well. When you look forward, you're also looking at a bookshelf. This is an LED lit bookshelf that really separates the head and shower compartment. There's also lots of drawers and storage found below this center island as well. The hanging lockers and the attention to detail, when you look at this and you see how they've done and they've curved the doors and hidden the handles, they've backlit the closets with lighting, it's just truly remarkable. As we move aft to the shower compartment, you have a separate sink off to the starboard side. This is quite nice. So you can almost have a his and her sink on this yacht. And then you have a full separate walk-in shower compartment. This is really nice. Lots of lighting throughout. And then again, there are two overhead opening hatches that just let lots of natural light and great ventilation into this compartment. All right, so as we walk back aft, we also have a really nice cabin off to the starboard side as well too. Both aft cabins have queen size berths. There's lots of natural light and again, great ventilation with opening hatches throughout. Well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you like more information in regards to the brand new 2018 Jeanneau 490 Sun Odyssey, please feel free to contact me at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.